Yo guys, Dolly Tatty, and today we are back with another FIFA 23 video. Hang on, there we are. It's almost 6 PM on Wednesday the 16th of November. Team of the week has been leaked, and to be honest, it absolutely reeks. Unless Riley McGree is the Silver Stars, it's awful. There's been a David Silva flashback SBC leaked as well. Let's go have a look. Silver Stars is probably going to be the best player in this team of the week. Not even kidding. I wonder what we're getting on Friday. We haven't even had any leaks for that. So, Stars. Linetti. He's Serie A. He's like the one below Hullet Gang. Three star. Dribbling's good for Silver. Defending's not bad. Physicals are good. Passing's good for Silver. Honestly, not too bad. He's not bad. Rest of the league won't be going for him. To fair, chemistry doesn't even matter anymore nowadays. I've got 4 games of that to do. 2 games and I've got Larin. 2 and I've got Lee Kangin. Or Kangin Lee, if you want to say it. Yeah, it's a bit dead at the minute, honestly. I don't know how they managed to make the World Cup content so dead after like a couple of days. David Silva's here today. He's 87 rated. His stats were leaked. 4 star, 4 star's nice. Not gonna lie, I was half expecting him to have a left wing as an alternate position because in the last World Cup mode he did. Pace is not bad. Shooting's good. Dribbling's real good. Passing's obviously real good. It's David Silva. He's one squad. Celebrate David Silva's legacy with the Spanish national team during the FIFA World Cup 10, 14 and 18 editions. I feel like if this is anything more than an 86 without an inform, 85, that's, honestly, that's not bad. If you haven't got a Liga team, I was going to say for this early on in the game, we're in November. It's, is that full Krug 86? No, that's full Krug 84, he expires in 20 hours. That'll probably be, ooh. Don't know why I favourited that. That's not even a player's pack. 84 plus upgrade, ladies and gentlemen. This is going to be 83 rated with an inform. Watch this. Oh, almost. We're doing it, because why not, you know? We are doing it. Also, they've changed the badges for icons and heroes. This is awful, by the way. This is gen... What have they done to icons? They've not even changed the badge for the icon leagues. Maybe they're adding another club into the icon leagues. Who knows? They have changed the badge. Yeah, look, hero. It's genuinely awful. I think that might be one of the worst changes EA have made. And it's not even like anything remotely important. But it is important. Oh, I have Toni Kroos. I didn't even know. I think everyone has Toni Kroos nowadays. Even if you don't play the game, you've got like a Toni Kroos matchstax card just like chilling under your dresser or something. Any fodder? we've got an 89 and an 88. Then our next bit of fun is an 83. Well, what do you know? Oh, we have an 84. I probably definitely don't need an 84 though. That's the thing. I don't have any 83s though, so maybe I do need an 84. Zero fodder FC. If only all the World Cup players could be used as fodder, then we'd be laughing all the way to the bank. We are going to get Wilfred Ndidi out of this, or some other bang average 84. But we do it for the content, you know. I'm not going to do a reveal because I can't be bothered. But also, I feel like I get better luck when I don't do reveals. Also, do note, if it's not a walkout, at least, the video is ending there and then. We didn't even look at the team of the week, so I mean, we might as well. Who knows? Toni Kroos is actually the best player in team of the week at the minute. So yeah, it was all leaked. There's Darwin Nunez, to be fair, who's probably the most exciting one because his ones to watch gets upgraded. Got an 86 Moise Keane. Right, we have Geronimo Rulli. I still think one of the best first names in football, along with Norbert Neto. We've got Sinkman. he can he is a centre back. Why can't he play centre back? He is a centre back. If he could play centre back, that wouldn't be a bad card, I don't think. Really, he's a goalkeeper, you know. Tapsob was faster. Anyway, also, the lengthy meta is apparently finished in the new patch, so Tapsob is 6'4", but he'll be useless anymore, because lengthy doesn't matter anymore. Numenge, probably the best one to pack, to be honest. Hoffman? Doesn't look too bad, to be fair. Pace could be upped a little bit, but shooting's good, dribbling and passing's good. Hoffman's not bad. Tony Cruz, obviously. Pace, Martin Odegaard. What rating is Europa League card? It's 87, isn't it? Just go for that, innit? Lindstrom, 3-star, 3-star. Edin Dzeko, you know. Moise Keane, however, I think this could be the best feature team of the week we've ever had. 4-star, 4-star, 6-foot, high, medium. Real good pace. I mean, real good attacking position and finishing shot power. Long shot volleys and penalties, don't really care. And real good dribbling. I'm going to say it here. This is the best feature team of the week we've ever got, Moise Keane. He's also doing the gritty on his dynamic image, so that alone is worth about 200k. We also have Darwin Núñez. Can play striker. So why can he play striker when he's a left wing, but Sinkman can't play centre-back when he is a centre-back? I believe that bumps Núñez's inform up to an 86. And on the bench, Thiago Jago could be a cheap beast, to be fair. Apart from that, you could be decent for Super League teams. This is Ian Fleming on fire with the championship at the moment. Hat-trick at the weekend. Unfortunately, still no Tuber Akpom in Team of the Week. So yeah, I would like to preface, if there's no special card or walkout, the video is ending as soon as the pack opens. Like, I'll comment on the video who I got if it's stinky. But here we go.